Welcome. You finally made it. Go ahead, hog the couch. It's okay. Now that you found me and my show. Although, who can't see me? It's too simple. Even a rock could find out where I am. I'm all around you, and there's no way for zillions to overlook what I am and the swarm that follows. It's the Leaf Pile, a show you thought never existed. Or me, I call myself Leaf. How do you do? I'm sure you possibly could not live without a glimpse of this show. Enjoy.
You're wondering who I am.
Secret, secret, I've got a secret.
Machine or mannequin.
Secret, secret, I've got a secret.
With parts made in Japan.
Secret, secret, I've got a secret.
I am the modern man. I've got a secret I've been hiding under my skin.
You're in a time warp, baby!
Right, you got the Midget Johnny Time Warp. Host of the Saturday Morning Time Machine on WFCS 107.7 FM, where the music still matters, making my broadcast debut. Here on 29 QZO, Cable Access Networks. And today, for our premiere show, something that will amaze and astound you all, my good friend Crazy George has been trying for weeks to get on my radio show to talk about a so-called scientific experiment that he has been working on. I didn't believe it until I saw the videotape. So my good friend Joe Dorito here at QZO gave me an opportunity to come on here and broadcast this tape. Now, little warning, this is not for the faint of heart. If you have a heart condition, or if you're mentally deranged or thinking about killing yourself, you should not watch this video. Now, I should just give you a little background about this video before we play it. My good friend Crazy George claims he had done a scientific experiment in which he caused little children's toys to come to life. I didn't believe it myself until I saw the videotape. You gotta see this to believe it, and then it's up to you whether you believe it. Roll them.
Oh, I can swing behind, but not for long.
Getting a little carried away. They're really getting into music. It's a real snappy tune. This is Imagine Johnny Time Warp, and you're on the LeafPile, 29 QZO, Cable Access Network. And for our next segment, about 2 days ago, we had an opportunity to go down to Guitar Center in Manchester and do an interesting little video segment. Now, I don't know if any of you have ever been into that store, but if you ever go in there, you'll notice all the little teenage wannabes in there wearing the stupid Metallica shirts. You know the kids I'm talking about. They're the ones with their pants hanging down to their knees. They're like making all these phony gang signs. They're like going, yo, 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 yo. And they think that they can bluff people and to think that they're actually into heavy metal and they're fans of Metallica or what. When in reality, you probably know just the one song by Metallica. You know the one. You know the song One by Metallica. Hey, yeah, there's this schmuck that plays guitar in there all the time. He hangs out in there all the time. This guy named Steve Cancer. Every time he goes in there, he plugs the guitar in an amp. It's the same old crappy rendition of Jimi Hendrix doing the Star Spangled Banner. And all these freaking wannabes, like, stand around him like he's Jesus Christ or the new Messiah or something. They think he's, like, the greatest thing since sliced bread. And he's just a schmuck with a guitar in an even worse band. If you've ever gotten a chance to see that's what they're being called this week, Warhammer Live. You know how bad they are. He's in a band, well, now it's called Warhammer. Just about every week the band changes its name because they can never get booked in another club after doing one gig. They're really that horrible. And we wanted to check out the phenomenon for ourselves, so we took our video cameras down to Guitar Center in Manchester to see firsthand exactly what is behind the Steve Cancer mystique, as you might want to call it. So this next segment is appropriately titled 2 Million Dead Wannabes. Roll 'em.
In the world of wannabes, there are places they can go to show off their non-profitable abilities. We here at the Leaf Pile capture an exclusive leader to this world. This man calls himself Steve Cancer. He is one of the chosen, smartly using a fake name and a fake talent to throw those wannabe worshippers a confusing curveball to hide the truth. We brought our cameras to the Guitar Center of Manchester, being that it is one of his perfect places for a king to have a fleeting moment of disposable fame for all wannabes to enjoy and worship him.
I'm in this band called Warhammer, and we deliberately get kicked out of every place we play. We only play pop-punk shows, because we hate pop-punks, we hate the crowd that they attract, so we play with all Connecticut pop-punk bands, and I play bass and scream, and we have three other people to scream, then we have this drunken Irish drummer who gets pissed off if anybody insults Ireland, so we get him really hammered before the show, and he just attacks people while he's playing drums, and we have this Whipple bat, and we wrote on it Grandmaster Flash in like tag style with a marker. And one of the singers, Joe, he swings the bat like this while he's screaming, you know, taking people out with the Whipple bat. And I have this tennis ball and a sock, and I just pound on the bass with one hand because we make up all the songs on the spot, and all the songs are like role-playing game titles from like Warhammer and Dungeons and Dragons and stuff like that. Like we have a song called Hulking War Stallion. The entire purpose is we just get completely pissed drunk before we play, make up all the songs on the spot. I have this tennis ball and a sock. I'm pounding on the bass with one hand, swinging the tennis ball like this with the other, like hitting people in the head. People have like taken swings at me while I play. I do the whole dead guy thing where I have the bass hanging like this and they smack the back, so it's hitting people, and we jump onto people. People are throwing stuff at us, and we've been kicked out within the first 5 minutes of every show we've played. We've played 12 shows so far. Another thing, however, is we change our name with every show we play so we can play again. But so far we called ourselves Puke Bastard, such as what's written on my pants here, Dork Crusher 40K, Warhammer, Penis Wrench, a whole bunch of other band names. But we'll always be known as Warhammer 40 Ounce, however. And come check us out.
Center, America's beautiful, renowned store where everyone gets a taste of the finest instruments without a down payment.
All right, Johnny Time, we're here back on the Leaf Pile. If you've never been down to Manhattan, you got to make sure if you go there, check out a place called the Spiral Club on West Houston Street. It's the cheapest fun you can have in New York City this side of a $10 hooker. Yes, that's right, and last Saturday night the club was close to a great local band from our state called Gargantua Soul. We had an opportunity to ride down on the bus with Gargantua Soul to the club, and due to a little mishap involving about 30 gallons of puke, we were not able to get the interview with them right on the spot. We did talk to one of the band members before the show began, and we got some great footage of the concert. The band was really awesome that night, and here we go. Aren't you glad it ain't elevator music?
Hey, turn around!
This is gonna be a good night.
Yeah. The fun is just beginning. Peace!
It's all fun until somebody loses a shirt.
I want to come to that tape.
Here. I don't care either.
Gargantuan soul rules.
Last time we didn't get drunk until we got on the bus.
That was fucking cool.
What about Fred?
I'm gonna leave the rest here.
Okay, so you can smoke cigarettes.
We're just talking about pot, dude.
Hey, what's up, man?
What's up, dude?
Who's here?
I don't know, he didn't want to go.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Why?
Because he's tired.
Bag.
All right, everybody, respect the bus. Don't puke and shit in the back bathroom like last time. Use our garbage bags. You guys can drink, smoke, whatever the hell you want to do. Just have respect for the bus. You guys are representing us. We're showcasing tonight for a lot of fucking important people. So if you fuck the club and you have like assholes, we're going to kick your ass, okay? Okay.
We're here on the LeafPile show at Opus's band bus to see Gargantuan Soul. We're really excited about this. We're going to kick ass. We're going to kick ass. You know, we're going to pick some names. We're having a great time. We're on our way to New York City, man.
Yeah, we're here on the party bus heading towards New York City. Party, that's all I can say. Oh, I'm Budsy, I'm the DJ. I play records, that's all. I manipulate sounds and noises. And yeah, these are our fans on the bus. Hello, fans, everybody say hello.
Fans!
Yeah, party. Party, yes. The debauchery going on in this bus is unreal. I think there's a crap game going on in back somewhere.
Get the loogie on his arm.
Oh yeah, baby! You play the ball!
No, don't pull over there, yo.
Don't pull to Mickey D's.
Why, so I can be like you.
I'm gonna get off.
What the fuck, man? I'm slipping all over the place.
I'll get a better seat.
Get some people in the back.
What the fuck?
Tribe Alive 5999 G-Tribe, the year of the divine. Woo! Come
on. Meat spaghetti sauce. Great!
pick up some fresh ones. They're really good. Need some cantaloupe?
No, I don't need cantaloupe.
I need honeydew. Wow. Wait till Dolly Parton sees these.
What is that?
Nah, what the hell's the name of this?
Well, it doesn't have a name. It's called fruit.
We're here at the Leaf Pile, okay? I've been here with the band, Gargantua Soul. We just got off the bus. We're here, and we're going to be interviewing them. This is Opus.
How you doing?
This is
Tommy Hits, mom.
He does some really fancy keyboard stuff. This is a guitarist, one of the great guitarists, leads.
Mark, I'm a guitarist. This is our drummer, Opus. Guitarist, Jay.
So, what kind of music are you guys influenced by?
Good, Jay.
Paul Anka, Neil Sedaka, Bad Brains, the usual.
Bad Brains here tonight?
Nah.
Black Sabbath.
So where did you get the name Gargantua Soul?
Oh, just I kind of thought of I heard Gargantua in a commercial a while back before they started a band, using it in different terms. Loved this, the way it sounded, and I wanted something that had to do with big, huge, and that's where it came from. And then Chris had something else in mind, and it kind of fit together. He had the soul part, and it kind of worked together, and that's what we did.
So have you guys played New York City a lot, or?
Yeah, we play a few times down here, 10, 20 times. It's cool. It's all good down here in the city, man. Having fun playing, watching that orange guy freak out, going to the city. It's all good.
This is our bass player, Lou. What's
up? How you doing?
Not bad. How you doing?
What's up, boys?
So how long have you guys been in the band?
I
don't know, 3 years?
3 years.
How long has Gargantua been around?
I say 4 years.
Big Jeopardy question. What does Gargantua Soul mean to you?
It means brothership.
Which bands do you like and which bands do you hate?
I like bands, NoFX, punk band out of LA. I like Rage Against the Machine.
All right.
I like old school Zeppelin, Sabbath, Hendrix. Those are my bands.
What do you want to say to TV World and the Leaf Pile?
Yeah, I just want to say this.
No more questions! No more questions!
Ladies and gentlemen! Tonight we introduce to you! Can't tell me how.
I grew, I saw, I fell apart. I'm fickle too, just broken heart. You're wondering who I am.
Secret, secret.
Oh. Buddy?
I've heard it was supposed to hit Buddy. Cromwell? Big time.
Big time? How big?
Inside sources. Inside sources say Cromwell, the Middletown areas, Clay Cullis.
It's a tragedy.
They're gonna rub their ass all over Clay Cullis' shit.
Oh, they'll be smelling it for weeks. Bunny's stench is pathetic.
And you know, I also heard a rumor that the bunny,
yeah.
The tail.
Now this is something you gotta hear. Listen to this.
Ready? I thought you didn't know yet. You got an extra press. The tail. The tail. Is it on the back?
I remember.
There's a little bunny muff or puff. A little fruit thing hanging out the front. It might be genitalia.
It could be problems. It could be balls.
It could be balls.
It like could be
one. You might start calling this guy One Nut.
Sky One Nut. Luke Sky One.
But this, people, this is nothing to take Sky lightly.
It is we have seen this, crazy.
We have seen the bunny and the bird in action. We do have
pink
a
pink bunny.
He's a little whitish.
And the bird. The bird is blue.
The bird is
has
bluish.
A wig.
Yeah. So, what we're trying to say, this is nothing to take lightly.
Yes.
They could be wiping their crap all over the things your children play with.
Bring diapers.
Something.
Because it's wiping its butt everywhere, and I smell it now!
They're
the
coming!
Bunny!
Yeah. Shows your booty, man. That's big.
The bunny!
This isn't real, right? We gotta...
No, this is funny.
We can't use this, though, can we?
Who cares? We're still watching. This is live!
This is live!
It's you live. Have us in your home!
Don't tell me!
No!
Okay, next up, what did you do? Well, we went over to this wonderful lady's
house. Oh, yes.
Tell us about it.
Yes.
The key of B.
The pianist, ladies, she's phenomenally... trained. She's been doing it for plenty of years. She doesn't want to say. She has some gray hair. She's a very nice lady, and she can play all the hair. She's just wonderful.
I've heard her play. It was majestic.
He was there.
Want to look at that clip, or do you want to talk about it a little more?
I don't know. Well, it's all in the key of B.
It's definitely in the key of B. I think we gotta capture her essence. Like
she says it all.
Yeah, she does say a lot about what we wanted to show, but the camera, the essence. You know, there's such a style about this lady, a great lady, that I don't know if the camera can capture it all. It's just, she has a great energy.
Welcome to the LeafPile Show. I'm B. In the key of B.
Something happy for us, B?
Yes, I bet you have it. Here it comes. I'm not singing this time. You don't want me to.
I'd love to hear you sing, B.
Right? Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a wonderful feeling. Everything's good. Isn't that a happy song,
yes,
Jeff?
Yes, it is. Hey, Mrs. B.
Yes, Jeff.
Do you know Chopin?
Yes.
I'd love to hear it. Can you play that for me?
I'd love to.
It's a great song. To hear a really great song.
It's what?
It's one of my favorites. It's called When the Saints Come Marching In.
Oh boy.
Anything you'd like. What song would you prefer to play?
Let's see. What I love a lot of songs. Let's think about this one.
They're looking at you.
Aha. Uh-huh. This is Christmas. This Christmas Eve to my friends. I do.
They must enjoy that.
They do. They tell me play that song. I had two birthdays today, and I had to play that song.
You had to play the song for
them.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday!
And I did it in this key. D. No, I'm wrong, Jeff. It's the key of G.
That's okay.
All right. When were you born, Jeffy?
A long time ago.
Oh, boy. In what month?
March.
Yeah, I was too.
She's the Pisces.
Yeah, and so are you.
So am I.
I won, and you're?
Pisces too.
And we like that, don't we?
Yes, we do.
Yes.
So well.
Thank you. I love doing that. I love the piano, Jeffy. Mm-hmm. And my favorite's a key of that key of B, you know. I love that.
My favorite key as well.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Very good. And you love to hear it, don't you?
I love B.
Perfect. I love Jeffy. Right. How do you think of that? Would you like to come up on the bench?
Sure.
And you're going to try something for me.
I'm going to try something.
All right, here I go.
Whatever it takes.
All right, Jeffy. Sit down there.
Okay.
All right. Now, what are you going to do, Jeffy?
I don't know.
Well,
you going to show me something?
Would you play the key? Do you know any of these keys? What's the name of that key?
C.
Yes. Yes. Good. And you know the chords, Jeffy. Yes. Very good. Can you play that Mozart? You heard
no.
it.
No.
You know your ear is excellent.
Yeah, it's right. been so long.
Look, would you play that C scale? Right up four octaves. Good. Look at that. Good. Do it a little faster, Jeff. Good. Can you do it faster?
I don't know.
Come on.
Oops.
All the way to C. That's it. Boy, Jeff, you're good. If it isn't perfect, I work, but we'll see what we can do. Here's your bed.
Thank you.
doing people can to make them happy.
Next, Dave.
Well, we have a crank call in store for the today's viewers.
Let me dial up them digits.
Pick a number, audience.
4, 3, 7, 1, 4.
Forget the rest. You pick the last two. We can't do that.
Oh my God, Sam, I'm sorry. This is Leaf at the Leaf Pile. What are you doing?
I'm sitting home watching TV.
Well, that's great. What show are you watching right now?
I'm watching NBC Jeopardy.
NBC and Jeopardy is the wrong answer. What are you supposed to be watching, son?
LeafPile.
How do you know? What's your
first
favorite show,
how
man?
You know?
How did you get us? We're on live, huh?
No, I just guessed.
You're a good guesser. Give that lady a prize. Hey, we're going to send you something here. We're going to concoct. What's your address?
Is this the Leaf Pile?
Yes, this is the Leaf Pile. Do you
My
want
address
any?
Is 4444 State Street.
Leaf
Town.
We're going to send you some fake dookie.
Hi there, folks. Ryan Vantos here, WFCS 107.7 FM. This is the Hours of Musical Purgatory. yummy. This is Ryan Dantos, Musical Purgatory, WFCS.
Your soul is ill, but you will not find
the Black Sabbath.
Stuff, man. Look at that. Well, anyways, that's our metal folder. I'll be playing stuff, by then, later today.
Falling in the ground, hey lady, will someone get me out? Can't breathe.
Oh, shit.
That's enough mess for one day.
Yeah, I think you all know what I'm talking about out there. You're not all that dim-witted. You're not brain dead like people say you are if you listen to death metal. You're the most intelligent people on the earth if you listen to death metal. You're the genius if you listen to death and black metal and war metal or gore metal. You know what I mean? You're a pure genius that walks the earth. You have more mental power going on inside your skull than, Einstein ever did. Right? I totally forget his name because I didn't think he was that much of a genius. Hell, he never graduated high school. Yet he's, he's the one who's the founder of, of the atomic age. Well, on him. Look what the atomic age brought us. All this glorious power. Yes. All this nuclear energy that powers our station and our loud amps to strengthen our most evil righteous cause. And now, folks, here is edible autopsy off of cannibal corpse. I hope you enjoy.
Here we go.
Here we go. Just did. I don't want the mask.
Sweet dreams are made of these. Who am I to disagree? I travel the world and the seven seas. Everybody's looking for something. Some of them want to use you. Some of them want to get used by you. Some of them want to abuse you. Some of them want to be abused. Sweet dreams are made of this. Who am I to disagree? Travel the world and the seven seas. Everybody is looking for something. Sweet dreams are made of things.
The half door. One day, an Englishman, a Scottishman, and an Irishman walked into a pub together. They each bought a pint of Guinness. Just as they were about to enjoy a creamy, delicious pint of the fluid, a fly landed into each of the pints and was stuck in their thick something in their heads, in their thick head. This man pushed his beer away in disgust. The Irishman took the fly out of the beer glass and yelled, "Spit it out! Spit it out!" Thanks. Good shoot.
It's viewing that you should watch. Spiritually, you should do it. I command you. It was the 11th commandment to obey God's law. Thou shalt wash the leaf pile 10,000 times a day and grow eggs out of your nose.
We walked into the room. There was a white porcelain can. You know what that can said to us? I had no idea. Please walk me to the park. You mean our favorite place? This room we were in was our favorite place. It was a simple task. It was so easy. It was like a walk through the park.
Please, escorts need to be there for you.
Our viewers need an understanding of our job.
We are eggs and leaf.
Taking you through the show of silliness and surprises. A variety of pixel to disrupt and provide a tickle for all enjoyment.
Enjoy.
Yeah. Oh. I love fall. The leaves come down. The weather is nice and cool, and it's so pretty. I love fall leaves. They just make you look forward to a lot of things in the fall.
My name is Judy Milgram, and today you're at the Shoreline School of Art and Music. The name of the show I'm on is Leaf Pile, and I'm sure you've enjoyed watching it many times. I'm happy to be on because they have so many wonderful things that they do in the community, and they're very interesting to watch. I'm going to give you an acrylic painting demonstration today, and I hope you will enjoy it. Here we are, ready to do the painting. And I hope you brought your seat belts because we're going to take off and I'm going to paint real fast for you. I thought since it's such a beautiful day, we're going to start with a pretty, pretty fall sky, very blue, because it's going to be an autumn painting. And we're doing this painting especially for the people who are watching Leaf Pile. I love the color blue. Very happy color. Some people think of blue as being the blues, but to me, blue has always been a very happy color because blue makes me think of bright days. And the brighter the day, the bluer the sky. And today is a very bright day. So we're using some phthalo blue. This is an acrylic painting, one of my favorite mediums. And I have many students who study with me, who start with acrylic painting and go on to oil painting and other mediums. And here's our blue sky. Just want to get it in. And skies are always a little bit paler on the bottom. So I changed from ultramarine or cobalt blue to a phthalo with a little white. You can probably see the difference on your set. And I'm going to blend this color right in for you. And blend it in with the bright phthalo. Need a little bit, the bright phthalo and the bright ultramarine. Need a little bit more color right up here. And we'll be able to put in the rest of the picture. When you're painting, you should always do your distance first, because the distance is behind everything that's in front of it. So the sky is the most distance. The sky, you paint all the way down to where you think you're going to start the land in your painting, because you want it to be behind everything, like I mentioned. And this is a lot of fun, just getting the sky into the painting. Now I'm trying to think of what would be fun to do on a nice day like today. And of course, playing in the leaves for kids is a lot of fun. And even the adults like to watch the kids play in the leaves. And let's say they were out in the country. And if they were out in the country on a fall day, everything in autumn is kind of orangey, and well, there'd be some grass growing out there, and I just would say, oh, what a pretty day. And a lot of leaves have fallen in the grass. You can see them all around here.
Yes, welcome to the Leaf Pile once again, children. Now, I have a few things to say to you. Okay, about the little derangedness that Leaf and Eggs were talking and yakking about earlier. Well, I know that, you know, the truth about that. I can tell you the full story. You want to hear it? Okay, this is a song originally it was a song written by Leaf about 2 years back, the night of a lunar eclipse, when he was walking in a park, staring up at the moon, or the sun covering the moon, or moon covering the sun. Yeah, it was the moon covering the sun, lunar eclipse. Well, anyways, make a long story short, he got himself stuck with a like turtle head popping out his backside, couldn't find a place to, like, you know, he wished he had brought his own little porter potty with him. He wanted to find something around the park he was in, but couldn't find the proper facilities. Shame on you people for not making enough places to go in the parks of Connecticut.
Shame! It's ultimately Aggie of you! Down line, Aggie, I say!
There is only one thing we can do to you. Make you watch the Leaf Pile and trap you in the bubbles. Excellent. Be ultimately evil.
I'm going to do some happy trees. But not just happy trees. Some very, very happy trees. And Oh, look at this one. Oh, he is so happy and jolly. And he has a big tummy. He is kind of like one of those trees. Well, he's like one of those trees you used to climb when you were a kid. When you were a kid, and if you are a kid, he's still like the trees you like to climb. And he has little feet and everything. Oh, or would you call them roots? Well, everybody has to have roots somewhere. And, oh, he has a big branch, comes around like an arm. Oh, he is a terrific tree. And just a perfect kind of tree. Well, for kids to climb, for squirrels to build a nest in, for birds to build a nest too, for that matter. And I think trees are nice. And I love the different types of trees, and you can learn to do different types of trees with acrylic paint. It's a lot of fun.
This just in. Now let's see. Ed Spring. Objective? Highly experienced recording engineer seeking part-time employment. Sounds like someone we should, like, you know, harass with some AE questions. Yeah. He needs the help. We need people to harass. Remember, that's two words. Well, anyways. Ah, he's done stuff for the hit factory, it seems. An A&R in New York. Excellent.
A band.
Also of a band. Let's see, what band? Oh, this is a card from Leaf's sister, one of his finest relatives. She's a sweet girl. We love her here at the Leaf Pile. You know, she sends greetings. Hopefully we'll be going out there, you know, to NYC to visit her, you know, sometime within the near future. We'll be harassing her and molesting her. And harassing Ed Spring. Ah, he's associated himself with a lot of stuff. Artist recording. Yep, we're definitely harassing Ed Spring. Oh, I got a bit of hiccups. That happens every now and then when I do my metal vocals. Another thing just did. Let's see. Oh, yeah, Hannah. Well, they did a thing. They did some spiel with Hannah, Leaf filming Hannah. Eggs decided to go interview her.
Hi, this is Eggs Currywer. Here at the Webster Underground. I'm here with my egg, and this is Hannah's field. This is the lovely Hannah.
Hi there.
Hannah, how long have you been in the band?
Let's see, we've been around for about 2 months or so. I just met the guitarist last month. And bass player I've been playing with for about a year. But everybody as a whole, about 2 months. My influences. I'm influenced by many people. I'd say Jimi Hendrix is a big influence. Ani DeFranco is a huge influence. Janis Joplin, number one. Wonderful musicians everywhere. Yes.
Sounds like her a little bit, but you know, she has a very good voice, but no, it's not her.
No. I'm not Melissa Etheridge.
I don't want to talk to you anymore. You have no more questions. I think she's sexy.
Thanks. It's really nice coming from you, though. Yeah, I like the blues. The blues are very nice. They're very good because you can put your soul and heart into it. I've been singing the blues. Actually, for about a year now. I'm trying to get into other things, funk, blues, all different things. I write most of my own songs with the band Canisfield, and
first, the egg and the chicken.
The egg came first. The egg. The egg. Because you are the egg. I love you, egg. I usually write the lyrics first, and I don't know, I just think of life lessons. I don't want to be like cheesy lyrics, like, you know, I like you and you like me. I want it to be something that touches everybody's soul, like, research your heart to pinpoint the pain. Research your heart, egg, because it won't go away. Research your heart, because it's here to stay. You don't have an heart. You don't have a heart, you're an egg. So I wrote a song for the LeafPile show. I don't know the lyrics yet, but you know, it's pretty damn good. It's about the LeafPile and creativity involved, because Leaf is such a cool dude. You love Leaf. I do. I'm glad. Okay, I was nice bonding with you. Alrighty then.
Itself, the cosmic puppeteer of the Old Testament, the wrathful alien space god from some corporate sin galaxy. In this timeless moment, which we call the divine immaculation of the Bob, Dobbs received the first of countless brain-curdling pronouncements which form the sacred prescriptures of the church. He was shown a vision, a world where all humanity was equally wealthy, rich beyond imagining, but without working. This experience, combined with his UFO-given sales magic, led him inevitably into the religion field. He quickly discovered the golden rule embodied in his classic saying, "They'll pay to know what they really think." The true subgenius can learn to think for himself, but only Bob can show him how. And so, Bob Dobbs founded his church upon a sandy beach of common sense, sense of humor, and dollars and cents. A likely story, you say, but it's simple, really. Bob is lucky, not smart. In fact, by the perverted conspiracy standards of intelligence, he is gifted with incredible stupidity. He lives in a perpetual state of contracted consciousness. This enables him to act without thinking, to surf effortlessly on the luck plane, to float down the fabled path of least resistance. In fact, to make $1 million every time he screws up. Thus, it is not his wisdom, but his divine follies, his holy blunders, which we emulate. The miracle is not in what Bob does to you, but in what he allows you to do to yourself. He brings the student to the realization that everything you know is true. Under the conspiracy, you're being ripped off every day, but you can learn to enjoy it. He called his seminars instant instructions for those who follow no master. He journeyed to Tibet, and under ancient holy men, he perfected the arts of landscaping and acubeating. He also began modeling for hundreds of magazine ads, leaving Earth.
Now this tree reminds me of the kind of tree when I was a kid that we built a little tree house in it. And we built it out of just sticks that we found in the yard, some lumber that was used by the carpenter to build a porch on our house, and he left a lot of boards and things that he didn't need, and we took all the scrap wood and we made this great looking tree house. It was so much fun. I couldn't believe it. And the most fun was sitting up there and having our own private place that the other kids didn't know about. It was kind of hidden in the trees, and this old tree kind of wrapped his arms around us and kept the house safe. And there's the tree house. And it had a little window in it and some doors. And even though we weren't the best carpenters in the world, we thought this house was the most beautiful little house we could have ever built. And to us, it was our second home. Now, big old tree. We had our favorite big old tree. And it was a happy tree, and it had a lot of leaves, and it was an oak tree. Trees turned very red in the fall. In the summer they were green, in the fall they were red. And I can make these trees with a brush. I do a little dabs like this. And you can have leaves like that, or you can make leaves too with sponge, and I'll show you how to do that. take your sponge and you tear it up so it's kind of crumbly. And you dip it into some different color paint. And we did some orange. We have some orange right here. And orange is a nice color for autumn. I love orange. Orange pumpkins too. I love to make pumpkin patches. But today we're doing the leaves. Put some nice bright colors in here. You see how the sponge gives you little separations. And the other colors underneath kind of work to give it a little distance, your darker colors underneath. And these leaves are all around the tree, like a little hat. This happy little tree, very, very happy tree. And it should be happy. Look at that house. Didn't it come out nice? And I'm going to put a little bit of leaf on this branch here. And a little bit, a few leaves over in here. And that'll give us enough detail. Now, does everyone have their paint goggles on? Because I am going to give you a surprise. We have a couple of eyes. My word. And and a nose, a branch that looks like a nose, and a big smile. Now, with a smile like that, we know that's a happy tree. On the inside of the house, there are some very happy children playing. And one of the reasons they're so happy is because over here they're waiting to watch the steam engine come down the road. Train does have a whistle, and it is, there it goes, and you can hear the children cheering.
Gatekeeper!
Very good.
Leap.
Thank you for watching.
My 2-year-old niece could do better. I suck, but that's great. I'm ex-carrier of the LeafPile.
Ryan Van was here. LeafPile. Ending now on the train almost. Soon I'll be in Manhattan. See you there.
Run away to New York City, man. Yeah!
Hi there, this is Ryan Vatos, LeafPile Show. Well, we're right here in the middle of Manhattan. Right up there is the infamous, one and only, a picture of Einstein. Remember all the shit, crud I've said about Einstein? Yeah, he never graduated high school. Yeah, he's the one who figured out E equals MC squared. Sure it wasn't something else he was figuring out with his left hand? We'll discuss that another time. Right now, we gotta keep moving. This is Ryan Vatos.
A lot of weird people going by. I just saw someone look like Bill Cosby. It was kind of funny. Oh no, look, it's... Hi! How's it going, man? Anyone want to eat eggs? Is that how, do you deliver pizza, sir? This is awesome. Eggs?
Eggs are called Dolly Parton? Well, quite frankly, her face was attacked by an egg. A really, really big egg. Went scrape, scrape, scrape. With eggy shell bits. And now the eggs are falling.
Wow. It's, who is that?
Statue of Liberty, New York City.
Hi, Ryan Vatos here. Okay, we're packing up from this quarter, moving somewhere else. Beware, we're getting crazier and crazier as we go along. Have fun, Connecticut.
Hello, folks. This is Ryan Vatos of the LeafPile.
Yeah.
Here at Melissa's place. Right? Leaf's sister.
Yeah.
She's awesome. This is Leaf. This is Eggs.
Eggs?
Also of the LeafPile, of course.
Okay.
Before we move on, there is something I must address. Okay. About Eggs. Earlier we were picking on him about how he can't write worth a damn on an etching sketch.
Maybe I should take him to the Mass of People.
He's 20-something plus years old.
Yeah, I'll figure it out. Take that ease.
He's still practicing with that.
But I'm damn good looking.
I'm sorry?
Get that dunce cap back on.
Okay. But I would have to take 135,
right?
Speaking
of why he's wearing the dunce cap.
Right?
Well, see, you wonder why three of us walked through Manhattan earlier this afternoon. All over the place, carrying
gobs. Well, I'll figure it out. I'll
ask
somebody if I get lost.
You built stuff. You know, trying to say things without four-letter words.
Yeah.
Well, two of those things happen to be these folding director's chairs. This is Exhibit A, one of such chairs.
Okay.
Where's the other? Well, it was supposed to be with Eggs. He left it somewhere.
Okay, sounds like a
for us.
Yeah.
All right, so I guess I'm
knowing anybody who goes walking through Manhattan with gobs
I'm gonna get dressed
well,
up
you know,
a big
stuff.
Freak or something. I'm gonna actually, I gotta call the witch's
something's
brew tonight.
Always tending to go missing, right? Could be your
we'll
wallet due to the vagrants and pickpocketeers, or could be something due to your own stupidity. Today, the stupidest person in the LeafPile happened to be the one wearing the dunce cap.
I will. I know I'm going to stay up all night. I took some ginger.
Get your head up there. Yeah, that's right. Eggs.
I know. They better let me sleep. I'll be
pissed. So, when we get back to Connecticut, if you people see this, laugh at them. Go, Eggs, you dunce.
Sorry, it's
Eggs,
crazy.
You dunce. Hi, this is Eggs Carey. Here with Ryan Spammin' Toast.
Yeah.
Spammin' Toast. Hi, this is Ryan Spammin' Toast.
That Eggs?
And this is Mike Miller
here. Hey, get me
he's on TV.
Melissa, you want to be on TV? Melissa!
I love you all.
Eggs?
Spamatos. Thanatos. Now this is a leaf pile segment. Hi, I'm here with the Statue of Liberty. I was going to introduce us to the real Statue of Liberty earlier, but we didn't get the chance. But I have a few questions for her. Hi. Who did you vote for in the last election?
That's a Bill Clinton.
Do you feel like you've been cheated in your responsibilities as your job?
Yeah.
Do you think you deserve to be a part of a union?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you get benefits for holding up that torch all live long day?
Yes!
We're here in New York City. We're here in New York, Long Island.
The bomb, right here. We're in New York. Forget about it.
What is it? Long Island. Long Island.
Hey, I think the Statue of Liberty has a...
Eggs!
...in her toga.
Leap up!
Okay.
Turn it off.
Welcome to the Leaf Pile. We're in New York, you know what I'm saying? We're in New York, we're gonna check out the fish, you know what I'm talking about? Forget about it.
Leap up!
Slow and steady. Stupid.
You ready, Eggs? I made this fresh from the Melissa's house, and this is my sister's great cheesy substance called Eggies.
Eggies cheese?
Yeah.
All right, hungry?
Hungry? You want some?
It's great!
Let's
go to the
bull.
I don't
know.
I
cooked
it myself.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, gee.
Would you take him? He's more interesting looking.
All right,
take him. Let's go, Brian. If you want some,
it's over here. I'll take a dozen if it comes out there.
Eggs. I'm dying.
Hi. This is Eggs Carey. We're here. Melissa's apartment. We just asked, her landlord, if she wanted, not landlord, whatever, the person that owns the place. If they wanted some macaroni and cheese, but they didn't want any, so we're gonna, later on, we're going to Witch's Brew to interview people. And the person, by the way, that made the macaroni and cheese is this fine, good-looking fella.
Not gonna use it.
Where is he?
What?
Eggs. Doesn't that suck? They don't want any eggs. What's their story?
Who cares? I know I made this awesome dinner and nobody wants any. It's not my fault the neighbors don't want this delicious treat. You know, I'm just gonna have to save it for later. Melissa, we can eat all this, right, tonight?
I'll eat it. Yup.
It's a good treat.
Fine, good
treat.
Yeah, here.
Yummy.
Yummy shells with cheese.
Yeah, yummy.
Yummy.
Cheese. This is Eggs Carey. We're in Melissa's apartment.
Not again.
Reef is putting away the yummy treat that we were
going to make this every time I come here. Man, I was asking. They just never want, look for us.
Dig it.
Mm-hmm. Cheese.
face to face.
Come with the leaf pile. Follow to the witch's brew.
Witch's brew!
Hello there. This is Rye Vanitos. The witch's brew coffee house. Oh, yeah.
Chewbacca?
How about this one?
Now let's go inside and check out the Witch's Brew, the fattest place, Long Island, West Hempstead. You know what I'm saying? Let's go!
Absolute.
Hey, Leaf Pie. Leaf Pie, welcome to the Witch's Brew. Yeah, witchy hour.
We're here for our cable action show, the Leaf Pile in Connecticut.
Yeah. Yeah, who's acting manager? The Leaf Pile. Do you do a paganistic witch's spells? What's your main coffee potions?
Well, it all depends. I mean, we got a couple spell drinks.
What kind of smell drinks?
I don't know. Anthony, take over while I,
All right. We're speaking to a second head witch, Anthony. How you doing? I'm right here. It's the Leaf Pile.
Nice to meet you. How is everybody tonight?
Okay, now, there's a question I asked him. He said you guys make smell drinks. I asked him, what kind of smell drinks?
I wouldn't even know. You have to talk to the dishwasher back there.
Hey there. Hello? Walking through the witch's brew. Everybody's rushing around.
Here at the Witch's Brew, we have all kinds of great things like the nightmare, the bat, the witch, the monster, all kinds of excellent drinks for you to drink with caffeine. Check out the stars.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Ah, menu. Let's check out the menu. You don't mind if we zoom in?
Ask him.
Yeah. Hi, are either of you a witch? A witch? This is the Witch's Brew, right?
Yeah.
How long have you been a witch?
About 2 years.
Well, what tribe or paganistic brew, breed, do you come from?
I'm just basically studying it right now. I really haven't gotten too deep into it yet.
The Rainbow Witch? Good witch or bad witch?
Neither.
Eclectic, are we?
Hmm?
Eclectic?
A little.
Can I ask your name?
Dolores.
Dolores, nice meeting you. I'm Ryan Santos of the Leaf Pile. Your friend here?
John Sam.
Nice meeting you, Ryan Santos. So, what got you into studying, being a witch?
I don't know. I think it was from all those witch movies that they had out. I started looking into it, getting interested into it, researching it. I asked a bunch of my friends when I was in high school, and basically they pointed me in the direction where I've been really learning a lot of stuff.
Is it really, really interesting?
It can be if you use it the right way.
Yeah. Do you believe really in any of it?
Mostly, yeah.
What do you think of the movie Blair Witch Project?
Leaf pile.
Alright, hold on.
This is one of the shops that they have vintage clothes and records and all kinds of good stuff. And this lovely lady working behind the counter, what's your name?
Lene.
Lene, how do you like working at the Witch's Brew? Is it cool?
Yeah, it's fun.
Oh, and there you have it. Cool place to shop as well. Can you hear me? We're here at the LeafPile show. My name is Melissa Leafette. Woo, 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 woo. Yeah.
The little LeafPile.
Watch it. We got candelabras and watch your step. All kinds of good stuff. Watch your step. No, I'll just screw up this place. We're gonna have this on a cable access show.
Hello!
Tracy's the bomb.
Hello, darling. Peace and hair grease to all of you. My God, it's that not that close. No, no,
no. It's the show's called The Leaf Pile,
yeah,
so.
What do you say, Connecticut?
Yeah, Connecticut.
Yeah, Connecticut.
Leaf Pile. Say Leaf Pile.
Leaf Pile. Y'all coming on TV?
Yep.
When?
Ask him.
Soon.
Soon when?
Friday.
Okay, so I'll see then, all right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Leaf Pile! 9999.
Almost forgot the code.
Eggs.
Eggs.
All right, battery's running out, kiddos.
Uh-oh.
I got change.
Here you go.
All right, have a good night.
You too.
Yeah. Oh, the light came on, and then there was light.
This is Eggs Carey, and we're here in a park in Long Island somewhere. And...
we are here now.
How you doing?
Observing Middletown Statue of Liberty.
Looks exactly like it. Not even close.
We the people. Give me your supper, your tired. Your eggs.
Eggs.
Hi, this is Eggs Carey. We're here.
There it is.
Statue of Liberty. Not even close, but closest we could come to the Statue of Liberty, because when we went to New York, we couldn't actually get
the Statue of Liberty.
It was very far, but this is Middletown's own Statue of Liberty.
I enjoy my sister's talents because I feel she sees the same in me. Whether it be playing in a band or playing solo on guitar, you know, or being on the show. Long Island Singers presents From This Moment On, a solo provided by my sister. Enjoy.
Come on. to eat, or maybe it's please. Keep away from her, except for Gino.
It's Johnny Time Warp here, and this is my good friend Blues Box.
Hey, how's it going?
Living proof that any no-talent hack can make it in showbiz.
Yeah, Johnny, you should talk about being a no-talent hack. If talent were gold, you'd be the national deficit, buddy.
Boy, sounds like you got a little cold today.
Ah, screw you, buddy. At least I'm good-looking, not like that stupid puppet Eggs Carey.
Oh, really? He has a puppet now?
Yeah, this ugly-ass coconut that he made into a puppet called Samuel Coconut Head. Haven't you ever seen it?
Well, not really.
Well, the only thing that makes me want to puke more after seeing that is eating the food down at Fresh Eggs Ristorante where they hang out all the time.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but don't take my word for it. You gotta see this ugly bastard for yourself. Check it out.
Okay.
Hi, this is Eggs Carey. We're here with my buddy Samuel Coconut Head. Say hi, Sam.
Hello, everybody out in the TV world. How are the folks out there? I bet you have some fresh eggs for me tonight.
Yeah, I'm sure they do.
Well, I like coconuts. How are the coconuts over here in the USA? You know, I'm from Easter Island. I like they're fresh over here.
Well, I don't know. I've never had the coconuts on Easter Island because I met you in a dumpster.
Well, I know they serve fresh eggs. How about coconuts?
I just told you.
Well, okay, I guess I'll just have to eat eggs then.
Anyway, we're here in the famous fine cuisine restaurant called the Fresh Eggs, located in East Palm, Connecticut.
Yeah, that sounds like a great place.
Well, duh, this is where we are. Are you stupid besides ugly?
Well, I know that you shouldn't make fun of my land, Easter Island, because every time I take you there, I take you out to fine cuisine and coconut.
Coconuts. You know, you can't just eat coconuts and say, wow, you know, there's dinner. You know, a coconut is, like, refreshing.
Oh, I see what you mean. You're gonna fill my stomach with the fresh good of an egg with yolk and stuff and cracked shell. Oh, what about coconuts? They still have a shell just like an egg. Inside's a great fresh too.
Except it's called whatever. You know, we're getting off the subject here. You know, the eggs here are really good. You know, they're at the salad bar, you know.
East Palm, Connecticut.
In East Palm, Connecticut, exactly. And, you know, we're going to have a great dinner because they have all sorts of eggs. They have fried eggs.
Well, we're waiting for that damn salad bar. Why the way line? The line is way too long.
Anyway.
Line's going to die out.
All right. We stop interrupting. Anyway, okay, you know, the eggs here taste practically just as good as mama's. What do you think?
Yeah, they have scrambled egg, boiled, sauteed, you name it.
Don't forget sunny side up.
Well, when is that damn bell gonna ring?
For a while, Sam, they're in the line.
Okay, I just wanna eat eggs.
You know, I can't wait to get these eggs because they're going to fit right on our plates and they're going to fill us up and we're going to be happy. So you will shut up and I will shut up and we'll all be hungry and happy and satisfied.
Oh, okay, you better shut up because I'm going to get a ton of eggs to get back at you for the last time.
You're going to get back at me for what?
What do you mean? Remember last time? You better not do it on national TV and embarrass me.
You mean when I... Oh, you mean...
That's what I'm talking about with you.
It doesn't even smell. Whoa, yeah, it does. Wait, is that the eggs that smells or is that my... God, you're going to be wearing that mask on your face for a while because I got a lot more where that came from.
And I'm not crazy about that fucking respirator that I have to wear.
You mean that thing that you think I bought? That... You thought I paid a dime for that? I'll tell you something right now, Sam. I found that in a dumpster by the hospital.
Hey, if it wasn't for you and your bodily functions, I wouldn't be in this predicament. I don't care where you found the damn thing.
Well, what do you want me to do? You know, you're wearing it. It looks better on you. It hides your ugly nose, your ugly mouth.
Hey, that's not funny.
Yeah, it is. Look at you.
Well... I don't care. I think you're ugly as sin. How about them bulls?
Well, that brings me back, you know, the game I was at, you know, the score was 10-0. And, you know, in the half of the game, you know, I wrenched out this massive air biscuit. just like that one, pretty much.
God, it's starting to smell bad in here.
Nah, it smells all right. Anyway, you know, the reason why, I mean, I had a really good, there was a really good game, because my favorite player, number two, played. And he made the game even better because You know, no one knows. I know his name, and his name is.
That sounds like he's number two.
Number two.
Really? Okay. I'm not crazy about sitting here too long, you know. Where's my damn plate, anyway?
Should be coming any minute, Sam. You gotta be relaxed. Food should be here real soon. Wow, our plates. Wow, thanks.
You're welcome, sir.
Sam. Oh my god, do you know what that means?
Oh, it means it's time for fresh eggs.
Yes, this is Eggs Carry.
With Samuel Coconut Head.
Starting up. We now resume to our regular programming.
Hi, this is Leaf with the Leaf Pile. I'm here with Ed Sprigg, famous recording engineer.
Good afternoon.
I'm going to be interviewing him for this evening. Having some coffee. It's great. So how are you today?
I feel wonderful, thanks.
That's excellent. You look good, too, you know? So how long have you been in the business?
About 20 years.
20 years? What kind of bands have you recorded?
Everything from gospel to Ray Charles to John Lennon to Nona Hendrix.
Yeah, enjoyed. I love doing the Leaf Pile. As you know, it's a very good experience, and I get to meet very unusual people, such as Egg. Ed Sprigg.
I like it.
Can you tell me some brief experiences you had? With these recorded artists, any experiences like something that happened that was very funny? You guys do anything that was like interesting?
Well, we would lock each other in the control rooms at night, turn off all the lights and the power, and then go after each other with extinguishers, fire extinguishers.
Really?
Oh, this was after 10 hours in the studio with Alice Cooper or
someone. Yeah, I heard that Jim Morrison, after making that song The End, he did the same thing, except he had to use the fire extinguisher on the whole recording show. I mean, just everybody that was involved in it, he sprayed the mixer, the engineers, and the walls, and it was really a weird experience.
Thousands of different experiences with these artists. Mm-hmm. Most were good. Some not so good.
Wow. Right. I like to record as well. I like sorting sounds around in an unusual fashion. Whether it be contorting my voice to sound like a frog, or mixing radio commercials to confuse the listeners. I like to record sounds daily. It may be annoying to some people, but for me it's just practice.
Would you ever record a frog going cricket, cricket?
I've done sound work like that as well.
Is John Lennon as nice as they say? Is he really peaceful? Like, because he seems very peaceful and nice. He seems happy. Is this true?
Yes, he is. He's very satisfied with his life when I worked with him.
Mr. Sprigg, how long have you been in the business of recording bands?
Call me Egg, please.
Ed, how long? Oh, Egg, how long have you been in this business?
Over 20 years.
Is it, did it start off as, you know, you went and got a job and, hey, how you doing? I'd like to try recording. Or did you go to college? Did you, you know, pursue anything into that field? Or did you just appear there and say, I'd like to record? You know.
Been a musician all my life. Had the opportunity to get a job at a recording studio and recorded good artists.
Wow. Meatloaf. He's cool, you know. I liked it better when he had long hair, but he's still cool. He's got a great voice. I mean, you got Ed Sprigg. All this $1 million worth of Warner Brothers records. It's great. Another Meatloaf one. Lecture Records. Wow, you've had a very good life, as I can, as we can all see here, you know, a lot of people would love to have this on their wall. You must be very proud of yourself, and it's been great interviewing you, and I hope to come down again and interview some more.
It's been my pleasure.
It's been our pleasure, too. This is Brian Eggs Carey with
Ed Sprigg, very known, well, and recording engineer.
Thank you.
Yes, you too.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Leaf. In haunting hours such as this, my name becomes Dr. Scare. First, I am here tonight to give a special presentation of transformation, this instant sweet girl, to Ghoulish Fiend. First, I will need a large brush and liquid makeup. Place white makeup all over face. Next, take black. Do under cheeks, around nose. Careful not to get in eyes. Then round lips. Make teeth. This woman's name is Betsy. More makeup! Now! Transformation! Tuck it under. Look good? Yeah. Voila!
We're about to pay a visit to one of our old friends, B. Hendrickson. Come on, let's take a walk.
Welcome. Come in. So happy to see you. This is the Leaf Pile, and I am the master of voice and piano, and we are in the key of B. And I'm B. I sing in the morning because I'm sometimes a little sad, and so I go to the piano and I play from Oklahoma. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a everything's going my way. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got a wonderful feeling. Everything's going my way.
What would you like to ask me?
Well, how long have you been playing this instrument called the piano?
I have been playing it. I started at 5 years old with my grandfather, who had a violin. I didn't have a piano. We started to sing.
What do you think the first song was I learned at age 5, Brian? You don't sing it anymore. Yankee Doodle went to town riding on a pony. And I loved it. And Gramp said, that's the first song you're going to learn. Now we're going to learn some more. And we went on from that in many songs. And then I started the piano later when I was about 6 to 6 and a half. And I didn't like the teacher, Brian. You know, Brian, you can tell when people love to teach. They do enjoy it. When I hear some of these players, the poor singers trying to give, and what happens? They overpower her. I'm so enthusiastic, Brian. I don't mean to do that, but you've got to have enthusiasm.
I have one more question for you. It's kind of one I wanted to ask you. You taught Jeff.
Yes.
So you must have taught a lot of people.
I've had 24 pupils in full. And I used to go in a car and all over Madison, Clinton, and I taught them in Killingworth. And let's say I had 2 very brilliant ones. They're now in the big world. And
did you ever do this as for a living? Did you ever teach?
I was paid, yes. That's what I did for a living.
You better get the phone. This is Brian. This is Eggs Carey here at the Leaf Pile. And hope you... Goodbye.
There's a place for us, somewhere a place for us, peace and quiet and open air, wait for us somewhere. There's a time for us, someday a time for us, time together with time to spare, time to learn, time to
It's a LeafPile channel, so give us a chance. Hey, what was that noise, brother? Check your pants. Just turn up the volume, see what's goofy. Find it in yourself to get real stupid. Here we go now, watch LeafPile grow. We're gonna take you through our LeafPile show!
Fire in yourself to get real stupid. Here we go now. show!
Enjoy. Hi, it's Ryan Vantos, LeafPile, here on top of the pool table. This is Cue Ball. Where's 8 Ball? Well, 8 Ball, he's getting ready to go out to the Red Dog Saloon. So why don't we go join him there? Because he's just won a major award. Here's Cue Ball trying to fit into the center. Doesn't seem to be wanted by everybody else. Shame. Oh well. Why don't we just hitch a ride with the 8 Ball? Straight to Red Dog Saloon. Enjoy.
Hi, this is Eggs Carey. We're here at the Red Dog Saloon. We're ready to go in and talk to some people. Our friends. They love us here.
Need to see some ID.
Ooh, what's this? Who's that? Ooh, killer boots. Who would keep their keys to a Porsche right underneath the car?
Come on, Rocket.
All people do? Yeah. Well, anyways, back here on the pool table, where the cue ball's still rolling along. Minding its own business, walking right into another gauntlet. You know, getting beaten to death by all the... She's a player. Wouldn't you like to be a player, too? That's worse, baby. Well, anyways. Okay. We went from the Red Dog Saloon to the Short Beach Saloon. Yeah, that's right. I'm Leaf. At the Short Beach Saloon, you know, with the Sludge Factory. They're a tribute to Alice in Chains. Excellent stuff. Gotta see it.
Hello? Is this on? Is this on? I am Crash Maton from Sludge Factory. Is this on? Can you tell me? File!
LeafPile!
Is this an invasion?
This is the LeafPile.
File!
Bob, I'm the guitarist.
Oh, Sludge Factory.
I'm Crash, the drummer. As you can tell, dude, I have no shame, man.
Rock and roll, long live rock and roll.
Oh my God, where's he going? What's going with the camera? Can you see me with that?
Oh,
Playing at Short Beach Saloon here right in Brantford. Tribute band to Alice in Chains. Good stuff. They do an incredible job. Bravo. Hats off to the drummer Crash. You know, and the crash he made there a little after.
Thank you.
for you in the key of B. Yep, playing the Ivanese and Everys. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm, she's excellent. Sweet old lady, love her to death.
What are you going to do?
Well, first I'd like to ask you a few questions.
All right.
Yep. Well, anyways, here at the Leaf Pile, you know, we like to interview, you know, people, of good stature and stuff like yourself, right, you know, and have some fun with them. But the first question is going to be one of serious nature. When did you start playing the piano, and what got you started playing it?
What year I started? I started at about 6 years of age, and I didn't like the teacher. So my mother listened. Mother was very musical. She said, "What's wrong?" Well, for one thing, she whacked my fingers, and I don't like that, not at six even. So we got another teacher, and she was good. She inspired me. She said, "Oh, I've got a young lady that can play, but she's got to practice more. And how do you feel about it?" I said, "I'd love to." Now, there's a difference, isn't there? And I love the second teacher. Okay, if that's your answer, I studied with her, and I have a picture I got to show a friend of mine when I was 16, and I gave a recital in Albany, New York. See, that's where I used to live. And it was pretty good. You would have liked it. All right? I want to answer other questions, whatever you'd like to ask me.
Okay, well, the second question is, what does it take to stay focused while playing the piano?
What does it take? And the next, I didn't get the next, what does it take to do it?
Yeah, what does it take to stay focused while playing the piano?
It takes some self-discipline. You have to think what you want to give. You're a different person. I'm now a musician. I'm not the same person, but yet I try to combine it because I love it, and I want to express that and the feeling in the pieces. When you love something, you give, and that is what I desire to do. So does that answer the question at all?
Yes, it does. All right. All right, Leaf. This is Leaf at the piano. All right, I will now sing for you Twisted Ones.
I've heard singers. You sing beautifully. If I can get you to bring it out more. Do you think you'd ever like some singing lessons?
Well, I've thought about it in the past, but...
You what, dear?
I've thought about it in the past, but it's...
Well, I wouldn't charge you. You know that any friend of Jeffy's is a friend of mine.
You will obey my rules.
You need some lessons. I'd love to help you.
When I speak, you will stop, and you will listen.
Oh, no. The Nazi. Oh, no, no. The Nazi. Oh, no. Oh, no. The Nazi.
This movie, okay? It's called The Neverending Story. It was back in, when was this made? 1984. It's about this, little boy. Goes into a, bookstore. And he, you know, decides that he's sick of reading, you know, the same old dumb...
Well, he goes into the bookstore because he was getting chased by those bully damn kids and tried to throw him in the garbage can. Well, I don't want to go in the garbage.
Well, no, think about it. I mean, yeah, he does go into the place to get high from the kids.
And then he comes across the old dude who has this book once.
Exactly.
Who says that his books are safe.
Yeah, he says your books are safe.
You ever read Captain Nemo?
Yeah, but it's basically about this kid, okay, who says who's not supposed to read the book. Okay, he wasn't supposed to read it. He takes it. And he takes it anyway. He doesn't care. He takes the damn book because he likes to read. He likes to read. So he reads the book and he finds that Atreyu is
loving a game.
Atreyu.
He's so funny.
Atreyu.
He's the human contact.
Atreyu is a little boy.
He's a warrior from the green...
To save our world.
He hunts the green buffalo in the meadows.
Exactly. He saves the sound. So-called.
Hey.
And basically, in this movie... It's a very good movie because... Ready? And the reason why I like this movie is because... Ready? Oh, no. Remember? Ready? Because... Oh, no.
Boy, do they love cake. Look at them, they're punks, they're shaved heads, they're mohawks, they're headbanging, drowning their ears out in the music that means nothing to a hopeless generation, thinking that is the answer to all their problems with a failed family and a drunken wife being dad with tater tots for a white trash family. Mosh on, hippies, mosh on. Oh, you don't like to be called hippies? That's what your parents were, that's what you'll always be, bowing to a false god and your marijuana and your opium. Buddhism taking its toll, free to bed, is strength, China strangling its hold on them, but we love you all, we love you, peace brother, the electric Kool-Aid acid test, yeah that was a good book, yeah if you like reading comic books, yeah what's up Scarface, why don't you rub your genitals in jelly, Scarcock.
Dude, it's really great band inside, oh no!
What a freak that guy.
Yeah.
Welcome to Toad's Place. Tonight, September 9th. Oh, it says it. I don't need to say that. It's local night. G-Chex Band, Tennis Field, Pepper Jives, and High Lonesome Plains. It's something that you don't want to miss. Just kidding, we're not going inside. Bar's closed.
They're in here already.
Oh, I remember them. Okay. Hi. This is where it all begins. Either you can or can't come in. And these are the friendly people that decide that. Might be a guy complex.
Will you let us in, sir?
No!
I believe we're listening to the groovacious melodies of High Lonesome Plains right now.
Thank you.
Understand it's time now to roam.
So long.
We try to be strong and wait until you come back. Wait until you come back.
Stop the music!
Where'd he go?
You watch your show every week, and it's so exciting to see a wonderful show, and I know that it's going to be right up there with Getty and Meatball.
Let me fall.
metal into my floor. You push and you monkey pull, electric beats and one world history. A life in Scribotico, what is the I want to live? Let me pour, I want to rip my life out. You let me pour, I want to scream tomorrow. You let me pour, I want to rip my life out. You let me pour, I want to.
Oh, right on, LeafPile Rock.
LeafPile.
You will be punished! I'd like to punish one of you now.